Say, I was in Ireland. I got to drink absinthe in Ireland, and absinthe is a liquor that they outlawed. It's supposed to make you trip hallucinogenically. So I got excited because I like to hallucinate. So I started drinking lots of shots of it, but really it's just a liquor. So I was just getting fucked up. I wasn't even remotely tripping. But after 10 shots, I fell to the ground, and I was trying to force the trip. Why is the floor as low as I can go? But I was just faking it, you know? It wasn't from the heart trip. It was force. Why is lemonade not aiding me? Acid was my favorite drug, because acid opened up my mind. Because of acid, I now know that butter is way better than margarine. I saw through the bullshit. When I was on acid, I would see things like beams of light, and I'd hear sounds that sounded an awful lot like car horns. When we were on acid, we would go into the woods, because when you're in the woods tripping, there's less likely a chance you run into an authority figure. But we ran into a bear. That was even more of a buzz kill. My friend Dwayne was standing there raising his right hand, swearing to help prevent forest fires. We got away from the bear, put his arm around my shoulder. He said, Mitchell, Smokey is way more intense in person. He's an asshole. I went to England to tell jokes. I wanted to do Smokey the Bear joke in England, so I had to ask the English if they know who Smokey the Bear was, but they don't. Because in England, Smokey the Bear is not the forest fire prevention representative. They have Smackie the Frog. It's just like a bear, but it's a frog. I think that's a better system. I think we should adopt it. Because bears can be mean. But frogs are always cool. Like, never has there been a frog hopping toward me, and I thought, man, I better play dead. Here comes that frog. I've never said, here comes that frog in a nervous manner. It's always like optimistic. Hey, here comes that frog. All right. Maybe he will settle near me, and I can pet him and put him in a mayonnaise jar with a stick and a leaf to recreate what he's used to. I certainly have to punch some holes in the lid because he's damn sure used to air. Then I can observe him, and he won't be doing much in his 16-ounce world.